Ram to serve.
Low one.
Loftovich, Gachev, and Zolpeto. Serbian team here.
One on.
Lam being backed up by Wong and Chan.
One, two.
Takes a big edge from Jevtovic. So Lam leading 2-1, just to clarify that. Scoreboard then catches up.
3-1.
And 20 years a professional, Gavin, for Marko Jevtovic. Astonishing durability in the sport.
Yeah, he's had a great career. You know, one of Serbia's top players for all of those 20 years, and a testament to how good he is that he's still able to be in the team.
You've got to foster such an enjoyment for the sport, but you've also got to look after yourself in that time, haven't you?
Yeah, 100%. A lot of taking care of the body. You know, I'm retired at 33, and Jevtovic is here at 37, still going. So, testament to him and the work he's done.
What you're really saying is there's it's open for a comeback for you.
Well, we'll see about that. I think I'm more comfortable in the booth here.
Well, let's see how things play out today when that. You start being reminded of how much fun you had out there. Lovely shot from Jevtovic.
Yeah, there's that long service. First two, tried short. Lam was able to attack, so if he can attack your short serve, you may as well serve long.
What will Lam be trying to do, particularly against Jevtovic?
I think, to be honest, Lam will just be trying to play his own game. He'll be trying to work with his own service that he's able to attack consistently. In every rally, he'll be looking to take the initiative, take the game to Jevtovic. I don't think he'd be too concerned about position or where he's playing on the table, as long as he's the aggressor and the one on the front foot all the time.
It's not just Hong Kong who have looked to move things around as well. Or rather, it's not just Serbia. Hong Kong have done it as well. Ho Kwon Kitt is sitting this one out.
6-5. 5-7.
Jevtovic with a 2-point lead here.
Yeah, just quietly getting the work done here, Jevtovic. Not doing anything out of the ordinary, just going about his business.
Yes, it has been a bit under the radar for that lead.
But that's what he wants. I don't think he wants to get into big exchanges with Lam. That's where, you know, he's going to play his best table tennis. If Jevtovic can keep him quiet, he'll do that for as long as possible.
6-7.
Very much like the opening exchanges of a chess match right now. No one revealing their cards. Still potentially playing themselves into the match, Gavin, or is that idea nonsense given the amount of warming up they would have been doing?
No, I think they're feeling each other out a little bit here. You can see Yevtovich has tried a few different services, some short, some half long, some long, trying to get a sense of what Lam wants to do and counteract that.
Brilliant running. Yevtovich takes a point which he had no right to win.
It almost looked like Lam lost sight of it at one stage. So high.
Well, that's resilience. Did you see that? He says. Wonderful from the veteran. I say veteran, but there's plenty of evidence of players going well beyond their 40s, beyond their 50s even.
Yeah, 100%. I think it's just a surprise to see Yevtovich here. He was out of the loop a little bit with the Serbian team for a while, and now that they've pre-qualified for the World Championships here, he is back battling with the boys.
Get that one.
Nine.
Yeah. To bring up game point.
He'll take as many of those as he can get, you can see. Almost unreturnable for Lam.
If you could do that every time, you would. Yevtovich with game point. Marco Yevtovich has got the first game. Yevtovich starts us off. Serves for Lam now, but Yevtovich doing it as well. The stamp of the foot when they serve, it's something that others do. Harimoto springs to mind, but what's the thinking behind it? What does it do for you?
Generally, you don't want the player, your opposite player, to be able to hear the contact you've made with the ball. So whether you've made a light contact or a heavy contact, if the player can hear that, they can really make a judgment call without actually seeing as to how much spin might be imparted on the ball. So with that stamp, you're disguising the touch of the ball and trying to gain minimal advantages.
One, three.
You know, over a career, does that have a toll on your stamping leg? I'm thinking of Yevtovich, he's still going, still stamping, and does that ever play into the strain on the body?
Not something I've ever considered, I have to say. That's I should really have a think about that.
It's certainly not a problem for yourself, obviously.
Yeah, it's something as table tennis players that we do almost without thinking. You know, it just becomes part of who you are and what you do. So,
lovely shot from Yevtovich. The idea that you can discern the spin on the ball from just looking at it then is not possible, unless you see the angle of the bat.
Yeah, I mean, it's all, you're trying to piece a puzzle together when someone serves. You're also trying to see the ball. Can you see the logo on the ball? If you know you can see the logo, then there's less spin. The ball is not turning as quickly. So you're trying to piece that puzzle together, and every little helps here. That's what the stamp is used for.
Four, three.
How good was that?
Almost turned around the corner blind and just bang, down the line. Flying past the Serbian, Islam really starts to look good on his forehand. Nice from the edge there. Interesting, and we can take another look when he receives again, but how close Jeftovic is when his opponent is serving. He's almost standing over the table.
Lam you're talking about, obviously, you saw it there. See Jeftovic serve one more, and then we'll see what you're talking about, Gary.
Yeah, exactly. So one more from Jeftovic and we'll get a chance.
9-5.
Yeah, so just watch Jeftovic's receive position. He's just standing really, really close to the table. Racket actually over the table, if we get a look at it. Game difficult to see from that angle, but let's see what we get here.
You can see that he is close, and yeah, that racket hand is well over the baseline.
11-5.
Game points converted, though. Five of them. Land.
One all.
A nice forehand swat kill there from Lam. Got to try and keep it a little bit lower, Mr. Jeftovic.
The repertoire of serves that are available to you, hey, Gavin, whichever you've got in your repertoire, should you be constantly trying to switch between them to keep things interesting? Or if you find what's working, should you stick to that and take it as far as you can?
Yeah, I think there's a combination of things at play with service, but I think number one, you have to be comfortable with your tactics and your systems. You're trying to build your own personal systems around your service and what generally happens after. Play your strongest shots, so that's number one. And then number two, you also have to consider your opponent. So maybe your opponent doesn't like to receive a backhand serve, or maybe doesn't receive so well against long topspin. The different considerations that you have to make. So a variety of things at play, but number one is your own tactical systems.
To set yourself up for that third ball attack or whichever your first attack is.
Exactly. What's going to create you the most possible advantage? There's very few players that are trying to win from service direct now. Mm-hmm. Everybody has such a good receive that you're just trying to create some small advantages on that third ball.
Okay.
3, all.
Let's see how Jeftovic's first attack of this point is off his serve. Good return from Lahm, went deep with it.
It's on a knife edge, really, because Jeftovic kind of received what he wanted. He got a long ball in his backhand. He got his opportunity to attack, but didn't quite make it.
So it was an execution issue on that one, rather than things not going the way he wanted them to.
Yeah, he received the ball where he wanted it, but obviously high quality receive from Lahm as well plays its part.
Just seems like there's an awful lot of thinking being done out on the table. In the same way, you have to think through a long maths calculation. There's an awful lot of brain power being applied to some of these short rallies, nonetheless.
Yeah, I think this game especially has become a bit of a chess match. Jeftovic knows that he's not gonna outwork and outspeed Lahm, so he's got to be tactically better than Lahm.
The fact that things are so close suggests that he's doing it quite well.
Definitely. He's containing Lahm very well. We're not seeing Lahm being offered any opportunities to expand and play a wide variety of, you know, topspin balls back from the table, or even with his backhand flick over the table. We're not seeing too much of it, so Jeftovic doing well to keep him in his box.
Lovely forehands from Jeftovic, reaching forward on the table. And he's able to catch Lahm cold a bit because he's stopped him from getting into any groove. That box you mentioned.
9-7.
Visibly unhappy with that, Jeftovic. Just again, he received the ball where he wanted it, just couldn't quite execute.
Three game points for Lahm. He's dragged his way to this point in the game. And dragged himself over the line for it as well. Puzzle. Some precious few exchanges, even like that. Jeftovic is dictating the rhythm of the match still.
One, all. One.
develop a few grey hairs without knowing how to control your opponent and keep them under your own steam. But then even when he goes into a longer exchange like that, Jeftovic comes away with the point.
Yeah, I think Jeftovic is just clever about when he tries, when he goes big. Nice switch from Lam there, forced Jeftovic back. Want as many of those rallies as he can get. Backhand flick, opportunity to play forehand after. That's the game he wants to play, and for once Jeftovic allowed it, but I think he'll be trying to tie it back up again pretty soon.
Step forward for Lam is countered.
Yeah, still going to, he's boxing really clever here, Jeftovic. Just sometimes playing a little bit slower, taking things down a notch, and Lam not quite ready for it. Used to a more speed and an impact game as he would be in Asia. Jeftovic has given him a bit of the old school here.
How they open up, similar to what we saw in the first game. Gavin, you must have come across plenty of opponents who've done this to you and kept you in your box.
Yeah, it's a really frustrating feeling for someone like Lam, who knows he has so much more to show and so much more to offer, but in this moment he's just got to stick to the task at hand and get a point on the board for his team, and at the moment he's in pole position to do that.
Six. It's a good shot. That's a really nice set. Extra dose of science been on the forehand. Tries it again, but he's countered. All about anticipation from Jeftovic here. I mean, that's about 15 years of anticipation that goes into making that shot. Don't have to move quickly if you know where it's going.
Got it. 6-7. Come on, right?
Jeftovic played a clever little ball, but Lam. But Jeftovic is battling.
And now close to Lam.
Just a sign of tension there from Lam, but
I was going to say that's what pressure can do. And you really know your game plan's working when an opponent offers a few gifts like that.
8-9.
Alon gets one back. It was there, wasn't it?
Definitely. Right ball to take on. Just didn't make it. The story of my life.
On the table tennis circuit or away from it as well?
Mostly the table tennis circuit.
That's okay then. So Lam with two match points. Still there, Marko Jeftovic. He's still battling. Jeftovic can take this to 10-all. He's got a real shot.
Oh, lovely winner.
Close the door.